Now we'll see how to create a function model based on a real-time scenario. So here the requirement is we have a vendor portal which is integrated to SAP. So the requirement is when the vendor log into the portal, he can submit a bill through the vendor portal. But initially we required to show the list of purchase order to the vendors based on his vendor ID. And once he select the purchase order number from the PO list which are raised on the vendor, then by selecting an individual purchase order, he can raise the bill and he can enter the at line item level. He will enter the quantity he is delivering and also he can attach the invoices. But here I am showing the first part, like when the vendor log in, how to show the list of purchase order through RFC. And second, once he passes the purchase order number, how to return the line item details. So this part I will show in this session. So in the previous session, we have created one simple function model, that is ZUD_FM addition. So here we will create a second one, that is ZUD_SAVendorPO. Create. I will use the same function group which we have created earlier, as inside one function group we can create many function modules. Vendor, PO list and PO details. Click on save. So this time I will make as RFC because I want to integrate with the portal. Save. Go to import parameter. Now from the portal I will be getting the vendor ID. Okay, so my RFC input first will be, that is we can use any naming convention, that is IP for importing parameter, Lifner type Lifner. I am making as optional. Now along with this I am taking one more parameter, because the first time when the BAPI will call will return only the PO list. Okay, so first time I will pass only the header details, and once I receive the individual PO number, then only will pass the details. Okay, so here I will take one more input parameter as, let's say IP_EBELN type EBELN, that is the purchase order number. If you see a message here, reference parameter are not allowed with RFC. Click on F1 to understand details. You have defined a reference parameter for remotely call function module. However, only value parameters are allowed in this kind of function module. Change the reference parameter to a value parameter. So here it is mandatory to make as pass by value, and I am making as optional here. Now third I want, okay, we'll continue with this two only. If my vendor ID is not initial, that I will show in the code. So I'm taking two parameter here. One is Lifner and second is EBELN. Now in the table, I want to return the EKKO table. For the purchase order, the header table is EKKO, as I want to return the purchase order list. So table is EKKO. So I'm taking as OT_EKKO. Here, as I want to define table, I'll be using like EKKO. Our table can be importing parameter as well as output table. And second table I'm taking as OT_EKPO. Again like EKPO. Now go to source code. Here I am checking first if IP_Lifner is not initial and IP_EBELN is initial. This means that initially from the portal we have received a vendor ID, but the PO number is blank. This means that we want to return all the PO of this vendor. Okay. Now else if, let's say IP underscore listener is not initial and IP underscore EBLN is not initial. Save, check and activate. Here I am taking one more parameter in the export as a message, EP underscore, let's say message of type string. Go to source code again. Now when the vendor ID is not initial, I want to select the PO details. So I will write here select all from EKKO into table JIT OT underscore EKKO where listener equals to IP underscore listener, because from the portal I will get this vendor ID. So selecting all the purchase order in the output table. Okay. Now if OT underscore EKKO body is initial, I will just write a message in the output. We cannot trigger a message here. Don't trigger any message when we are creating function module RFC. Always pass that message through our exporting parameter or to exceptions. So I am passing in the exporting parameter EP underscore message. No purchase order found. Okay. So first we'll test only the header table, that is how it is returning the EKKO value. For that, click on execute button. We can test the function model through SV37 only. Now we'll enter some vendor ID here. So I'm entering one ID here, vendor ID, and click on execute. So now you can see in the output table OT underscore EKKO, there are 181 records. Okay, so you can see the 181 records are there for that vendor in my development system. So in this way, we have written the header details. Now let me pass the wrong value. I'm adding X here. Now if I pass the X, this table is blank and you can see the exporting parameter, that is EP underscore message, indicating that no purchase order found. In this way, I can trigger the exporting message. Now, as a call will be from the third party vendor, from third party. So whenever there is third party software involved, always use the conversion exists. So when it is incoming, always use the conversion exists alpha input. As we are not get any error here, and we got the output because this is SAP system, the system automatically add a leading zero. Here our ID is 302285. But actual length of this field is 10 character. So while you are testing in SAP only, system already add the leading zero. But when it is coming from outside, so we have to add the leading zero inside our code. So here we'll add the conversion exist, go to pattern, conversion exist alpha input, call this FM. And here pass the input parameter. So this will add leading zero even though when it is called from the outside system. Okay. Now this will be done with the first PO details header value. Now we'll do the second part. Here my purchase order number is blank. That's why it is executing this block. Now in this case, here I want to pass the line item details only. So what I will do this time, I'm not checking anything related to listener here. For the given purchase order number, I'm just returning the values. Select all from EKPO into table OT underscore EKPO where EBLN equals to ip_ebeln. This time I'm checking the ebeln and I'm returning the value. Okay, now again the same. No purchase order found if my EKPO table is blank. Fine. Let me test again. So here I'll pass the vendor ID, and along with vendor ID, I'm also passing the purchase order number, that is 4 times 0. I'm passing one number, 7111, and when I execute, so this time we can see instead of EKKO, I got my value in the EKPO table. There are 5 line items which will get returned to the portal. This function we can also call in the web program if we required. Now let me pass some wrong purchase order number. So now this time 0, and you can see the no purchase order form. So in this way we can create the function module, and those details we have to give to the developer, like what value they have to pass and return which table you will get. Now here I use the standard table, and let's say you want to select the data from different table, just like we create an internal table or a structure. Now here we cannot declare an internal table in the source code and pass that table data in the output. So if you have any requirement, as here we want to pass only the purchase order number, let's say 2-3 field purchase order date, so we don't require actually this complete table. But if you want to save the time, or just for testing or demo purpose, generally use the complete standard table, otherwise create a custom one as a structure. So now let's say instead of the whole details, I want to return only the purchase order number and the ER date, that is the purchase order creation date. I will pass only EBALN and that is the AE date. Okay, so how to create a custom structure and assign here? For that we have to go to SE11. Go to data type and write ZUD_str_EKKO. Okay, this structure I'm going to use. Click on create structure, enter structure for EKKO portal interface. So my first parameter will be EBELN, because I want to pass this value same as EBELN. As is a structure, so there is no primary key. And my second field will be AE date, that is of type ER date. So here I have created two field in my ZUD_str_EKKO structure. Save, check, and activate the structure first. Now we created the structure here. We'll use this in our function module. Go back to our RFC, and instead of OTEKKO here, I am assigning my custom structure. Save, check, is still no error. First activate. Now I don't want all the fields, so what we'll do here, instead of select all, we'll write here select EBELN. Always select the value only which we required to reduce, to improve the performance. And second, I want AE date from the EKKO into table OT_EKKO. Check and activate. Again, do a quick test whether it is working or not. So I'm entering my again vendor ID here. Now, every time if you require to test some data by passing the multiple values, so after entering value here, we can save this as a variant. Okay, so next time we can simply select from the test directory, the value will come automatically. Okay, now this time I'm passing this vendor number. Again, we can see the 181 record. Go inside. Now this time we can see only two fields, because earlier I had used the standard table EKKO, then I replaced that with a custom structure with only the required two fields. Okay, so in this way we can create a RFC with the importing parameter, giving a message in the export. We have also seen how to use the tables, a standard table, and also how to use a custom structure as a table output and source code. So in this way, we done with this session with a real-time scenario on creating a function module for the vendor purchase order details. Thank you.